Hi, Ganiel. Good morning. Thank you for joining us in this interview. How are you?
I'm okay. Thank you so much for taking time to, you know, get to know me more. Thank you.
And so anyway, let's get the interview started. Now, recently, it was revealed that you are one of the candidates for this year's Miss World Philippines. We know that you're not new in the pageant scene, but can you share to us, nung bata ka ba, ito na talaga yung gusto mong gawin, ito na talaga yung dream mo?
I would definitely say that it has always been a dream na maging beauty queen. But growing up, I think it was more of my sister. Siya talaga yung naging inspiration ko din to actually join beauty pageants. Isa sila sa mga namilit sa akin to join beauty pageants. And I'm just so happy na pinilit nila ako nung bata ako. And now that I'm here, still joining. This is actually my third pageant. And I'm just really grateful that they're there supporting me all the way.
When did you realize na you want to be a beauty queen? Like, meron ka bang specific time in your life na light bulb moment, gusto kong maging beauty queen?
I think it would be the time when I became a courtside reporter for UAAP. I was a reporter first before I became a beauty queen for Mutiana Pilipinas. Nung nag-start ako mag-TV, naisip ko rin, kasi yung mga tao mismo, yung mga fans, nagsasabi na, I think you can join beauty pageants. And then I would tell them na, hindi, kasi reporter na ako and mas gusto ko maging reporter. Pero nung mas marami ng tao, mas nag-e-echo yung gusto nila na mag-pageant ako, parang lumakas ang loob ko. Iba rin talaga yung natutulong ng mga tao coming from, or iba rin talaga yung natutulong ng mga tao na nanonood din sa'yo. Siyempre, alam nila kung ano yung rehistro mo sa camera, paano ko magsalita. So, ayun, thankful din ako sa kanila, of course.
Meron ka bang Filipina beauty queen na you idolize the most? Like, you look up to them talaga?
It would definitely be Pia Wurtzbach. You know, she set the standard so high during her reign. And she's just so lovely, very down-to-earth and humble. Na-interview ko na siya a lot of times. Up until now, actually, she's somehow my peg. Pag may mga styles ako, gusto ko parang Pia look ako. So, up until now, yes. Si Pia talaga yung ano ko, yung ina-idolize ko na beauty queen.
During your ano, your application for Miss World Philippines, you said na you want the Miss World crown or nothing. Are you ready not to win the Miss World Philippines title?
Alam mo, Sheila, when you think so much about winning, parang there's lesser chance for you to think about losing. And that's what I'm doing right now. I'm trying to attract positive thoughts all the time. And I just really want to stand by what I said. It's really Miss World or nothing because I'm really aiming for the world. Yun talaga yung gusto ko. Diba sabi nga nila, sabi na ng parents natin, pag may gusto ka, i-target mo na agad yun. Yun na agad yung i-goal mo. Kaya, yes, Miss World or nothing.
Nice. It's nice to hear. You also mentioned before na na-meet mo na yung Miss World President. Tama ba?
Yes, yes. Tama.
Do you consider that as a premonition, parang ganun, na you're meant to become their title holder?
A big word yung premonition. Pero to answer your question, yes, I think that was back in 2019 when I met Miss Julia Morley in Quezon City. She was with the other queens, yung Miss World queens, and I interviewed them. You know what's really exciting about this? When we were talking after the interview, she was asking me if I would join a pageant anytime soon, and I said yes. And she said, I hope to see you soon. So if ever talaga maklish natin yung Miss World Philippines crown, I would be really happy to see her in Puerto Rico, kung saan talaga pwede ko masabi sa kanya na, remember the time na nag-interview tayo and you asked me to join or you asked me if I'm gonna join the pageant anytime soon. I would definitely say this is it. So sana ma-recall niya din ako. Sana maalala niya ako somehow. Kung sakaling manalo tayo dito sa Pilipinas.
Yeah, claim it. Anyway, being the public manager, being in the public eye for quite some time now, since your job is a reporter, and before that you mentioned nga na you were a courtside reporter. Do you think na yung name recall, it's a big factor in winning a pageant title?
Well, I don't think it is. Though eyes are on you, I feel like it'll always depend on your performance, how you do well during the course of the competition. Parang kumbaga, kahit sino ka, it won't matter kasi back to zero. Like, also, we have different judges there. all you have to do is, or all you have is just pure confidence. Kumbaga, kung confident ka naman in front of them and you can speak very well or you can showcase yourself very well, then I think doon mo maka-capture. But really, pagdating sa names or sa public eye, kung paano, kung gaano ka na nila kakilala, I don't think so. Eyes are on you, pero yun, kaya nga mas lalo ka magsistep, magsistep up with your performances because they're looking at you. Pero yung ibang ano, parang feeling ko back to zero yan.
Kumbaga parang siguro additional factor lang na the people know you kasi may support ka na from fans, ganyan. But the thing
yeah,
is...
Yeah, exactly. It's just an additional... Yeah, exactly. It's just an additional factor dahil nga, yun nga, may mga, may fans na. Pero yun, I think back to zero pagdating mo dun. Kasi, you know what? I'm also standing shoulder to shoulder with 44 beautiful candidates. I swear, I saw all of them. Personally, ang gagaling talaga magsalita. Each and everyone has their own potential talagang. So, I think talagang pukpukan, bakbakan yung ano yung Miss World Philippines this year.
And if you win, how do you plan to use the Miss World platform, Miss World Philippines platform, in pushing forward your advocacy and charity groups?
You know what? I strongly align myself with the core of Miss World, which is Miss World Philippines, which is Beauty with Purpose. 2 years ago, wait lang, tumatawag yung daddy ko. I strongly align myself with the core of Miss World Philippines, which is Beauty with a Purpose. You know, building a solid advocacy is one. It has to be genuine and authentic. So 2 years ago, I started this advocacy called People I Met. It is a social media movement that aims to share and tell stories of normal yet incredible people I meet. I'm deeply rooted in what I do as a journalist, and my mission is to, you know, share their stories and in the hopes of somehow alleviating their life situations and send across the message that helping is not hard, to make a difference in this world. So I hope that I could amplify more voices, I could amplify more stories if ever I win the title.
Last one lang from me. I know that your mom is here and some of your sisters, but your dad and other sister are in Singapore. How does your family support you in this endeavor?
You know, nasabi ko nga kanina, growing up, sila din naman talaga nagsabi sa kanila, I think you can do beauty pageants. But then, hindi naman ako agad naniwala sa kanila. But you know, my dad, because he doesn't know anything about Filipino showbiz, may mga Filipinos daw na nagpupunta sa kanya doon and would ask him, is Ganiel Krishnan your daughter? And then he'll say, yes, why? Minsan daw kinakabahan siya na baka ano daw nangyayari sa akin, like bakit daw kilala daw ako, ganyan. And then they would tell him na, oh, you know, she's a beauty queen in the Philippines. Oh, or you know, she's a journalist in the Philippines. Minsan kasi hindi ako nagkikwento sa dad ko kung ano talaga ako dito. Like minsan, I mean, kung sino talaga ako, anong ginagawa kong trabaho. Sinasabi ko lang sa kanya na reporter ako. But he doesn't know that I do Star Patrol. He doesn't know anything about that. Yung celebrity patroller ako. So nagugulat na lang siya. But now, when I started posting about Miss World, I also continue to send him yung mga pinopost ko na rin on social media just so, you know, meron na siyang alam on what's happening. Pero kailan lang, neto lang, nagtanong na naman siya sa akin because nag-trend pala yung photo na sasali nga ako. Saka yung sinabi ko na it's Miss World or nothing. So parang he was asking me, sabi niya, ano daw ba yun? Bakit daw may mga ganun daw ako sa social media? Saka bakit daw tinatanong daw siya ng mga Filipinos doon? Sabi ko, I joined the pageant and yun nga yung naging statement ko, it's Miss World or nothing. He would always remind me to just be humble, you know. My dad and my mom, they would always remind me to be humble. And to be honest, nasasabi ko talaga, yung mom ko kailan lang after the interview in Red Hotel in Cubao, she called me, she was crying. Sabi ko, ba't siya umiiyak? Hindi naman ako nanalo or anything. Kinakabahan lang daw siya. Siyempre, sobrang proud daw siya as anak niya daw ako and happy sila. minsan nagiging emotional din ako, to be honest, pagdating sa kanila kasi sila talaga yung tumulong din sa akin kung sino talaga ako. So, ano, I'm really happy and blessed. Very grateful to have my parents and of course my sisters.
Last na lang, may we know kailan yung start ng competition and any message to your fans? Call on them to support you.
Again, what's your first question again?
Kailan yung start ng competition?
And ano yung sunod na question?
And message to your fans na to support you in this journey.
Actually, up until now, we don't have the final dates on when the competition is going to be held. And also, on where the competition is going to be held and when. Pero I'm just up from the bottom of my heart. I'm just so grateful for all the pageant fans who has been supporting me and all the girls competing for the title. Lahat po kami, maraming salamat po sa inyo. Hindi po kami makakaakyat ng entablado ng talagang confidence and talagang grace kung hindi po dahil sa mga pageant fans, mga Filipino pageant fans na talagang sumusuporta sa mga beauty queens ng Pilipinas. Again, thank you so much for giving us so much confidence. Kayo po talaga yung nagdadala din sa amin, of course. Thank you so much for believing in us.
On that note, thank you also, Ganiel, from us at ABS Digital for granting this interview and we wish you luck. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ABS-CBN. Thank you.